I want to tell you something very important. You know, whenever you come to worship the Lord, whenever you come to church, don't come here with the attitude, what I am going to get. You know what is that? During the worship, was I able to worship? Was the sound? Was the light? Oh, I felt very dry today. That worship leader could not sing the way the other worship leader sings. You know, we come here to give to our God. We don't come to receive here. Please, if this is in your mind, then you and me, we need to renew our mind. We come here to give unto the Lord. Amen. We come here to worship Him in spirit and in truth. We come here so that we can forgive, so that we can partake of the bread and cup. Again, give. We come here to bless His kingdom. Again, we give when we worship the Lord in our giving. Hallelujah. When we testify, we give again to glorify God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we come here to give. So never have that attitude, oh, I didn't get anything today. When you enter, tell the Lord, Lord, I want to give you my best today. Amen? I'm going to give you. I'm going to open that alabaster jar and I'm going to pour out my best to you, Lord. Thank you for giving me this opportunity so that I can worship you here. We need to have that mindset. And once you come with that attitude, you will not bother what's happening around you. You will be drowned in praising your King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. 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 Tell your neighbor that you are in the right place. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, you are a child of God. And the Lord is watching you. You know, you have been photographed every day. Do you know this? Wherever you go, there are cameras all over. You know this? You can have your recordings all over the place, wherever you go. Because there's cameras which are watching you. Every move of yours. There are cameras here in the school. There are cameras, you'll see it on the road. There are cameras everywhere. So you are being watched. And I want to tell you something today. The entire heaven's eyes are over you. Amen. The Lord watches you when you cry, when your heart breaks. The Lord watches you when you feel lonely, when you feel that you are the worst loser on this earth. The Lord watches you in every thing that you do. And I'm going to show you through the word of God. Are you ready? Amen? Hallelujah. Please turn your Bibles to a beautiful scripture. Genesis chapter 16 and verse 7. This is Hagar who was running away from Sarai. Because she was mistreated. She is pregnant. She is afraid. She is fearful of everyone around her. And she runs right in the desert. And it says here, let's look at 7. It says in this verse that the angel of the Lord found her, right? Can you see the eyes of the Lord? When you are in your deepest sorrow, when you are in pain, the heaven will find you. The heaven will track you down. Amen? There are so many things happening around you. You are not able to see it because you are enabled and you are unenabled. So this woman runs away and she runs right into God. It says in verse 10 and 11, then the angel of the Lord said to her, look at this. I will multiply your descendants exceedingly so that they shall not be counted for multitude. And the angel of the Lord said to her, behold, you are with child and you shall bear a son. You shall call his name Ishmael because the Lord has heard your affliction. Look at this. First, the heaven finds Hagar. Second, angel speaks a blessing over her life. I want you to see the pattern here. What happens when the Lord speaks a blessing over you? What happens is that your heart becomes strong and your confidence gets deeper in the Lord. And what a lovely scripture it is. It says here, so she named the Lord who spoke to her, 11, 12. It says here, he shall be wild man, his hand shall be against every man and every man's hand against him, and he shall dwell in the presence of his brethren. We see, God tells her everything. What she is, there are many single women, single mothers who are going through trials in their life. We may not know. They're running away from problems. They're running away from people. Maybe you are that person. Maybe you are that father. Maybe you are that brother. Maybe you are that son. The Lord will reach out to you and he'll speak a promise. You are a child of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Heaven is watching you. Can we declare it? What we declare. Amen. Because I want this time to be a prophetic time that no one should fear anything. Because heaven makes it a point to reach to you wherever you are in whatever situation you are. Amen. Please rise up with me and let's declare it. We are going to declare it many a times today. Hallelujah. Hori khana narama. What is not happening? What you are stuck in? Heaven speaks to you that you are getting your victory now. Amen. Please be seated. We're going to declare this again and again because we are going to break something that is holding us. Then she called the name of the Lord who spoke to her. You are the God who sees. For she said, have I also here seen him who sees me? Hallelujah. She names the Lord. She says, you are El-Roi who sees. Amen. Are you excited that you're not alone? Whatever that you're going through, the Lord is seeing you at this time. Hallelujah. Because God's camera, his eyes are over your life. Proverbs chapter 15 and verse 3 says, the eyes of the Lord are everywhere, keeping watch on the wicked and good. Amen. Even if we have been bad, he never stops looking at us. Are you understanding what I'm trying to say to you today? Second Chronicles chapter 16 and verse 9. For the eyes of the Lord range throughout the earth to strengthen those whose hearts are fully committed to Him. Amen. The Lord is committed to us. Are we committed to the Lord? Amen. He has declared Himself as our Father. Do you have a relationship with Him as His child? Just don't say it. Just don't sing it for the sake of singing. Just don't do it for the sake of doing. Believe that you have an Heavenly Father sitting above, and He's all out. He's all out. He's all out to support you, to help you. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Let's look to another runaway. The first one was Hagar. Let's look to another runaway. And his story, you'll find him in Exodus chapter 3, verses 7 to 8. And his name is Moses. I was studying the word of God and I saw that at the age of 60, he is taking care of his father-in-law's flock. Not a very good profile, right? To be in LinkedIn. At the age of 60, failed. Living in isolation, not wanting to meet the world. Afraid to face. And it says, then the Lord told him, I have certainly seen the oppression of my people in Egypt. I have heard their cries of distress because of the harsh slave drivers. Yes, I'm aware of their suffering. So I have come down to rescue them from the power of the Egyptians and lead them out of Egypt into their own fertile and spacious land. It is a land flowing with milk and honey, the land where the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, Jebusites, all the Ites now live. The Lord says, I myself have come down. The Lord Himself will come down for you. Amen. In that situation where you are struggling. I do not know what struggle you're going through. That person who's not allowing you to go. The Lord is going to touch the heart of that person. It's all about God here. He said, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. But we see Moses protesting here in verse 11. But Moses protested to God. Who am I to appear before Pharaoh? Who am I to lead this people of Israel out of Egypt? Moses' response was based on what happened in his past life. People. Hagar ran because of people. Moses is running away because of people. Somebody said something and he has closed the shutters. It's all about God. God is saying, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. And suddenly Moses talks about himself. There's nothing to do with him. There's nothing to do with us. It's God who is going to give us breakthrough. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't be disappointed. Tell your heart, be courageous. Tell your heart, be courageous. Be strong. Be confident. That I'll see the goodness of the Lord in the land of living. Hallelujah. I'll see the goodness here where you have placed me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you know why Moses was talking? I will take you to his past in Exodus chapter 2 and verse 14. I have my Message Bible, but whatever version comes in, read it. The man shot back. Moses was trying to help his brethren. Who do you think you are? Telling us what to do? Are you going to kill me the way you killed the Egyptian? Then Moses panicked. Words gotten out, the people know about this. Moses has not forgotten this incident, and everything in his life revolved around this conversation. People have spoken negative things to you. People have insulted you, and you are dwelling on that. Rise above it in the name of Jesus. If your parents have spoken anything negative, rise above it in the name of Jesus. If your spouse has spoken negative things about you, rise above it in the name of Jesus. If your boss, if your neighbor, if your friend has spoken anything negative, rise above it. It's not Moses who's going to deliver the Israelites. It's God who's going to deliver. Amen. It's not about us. It's not about Moses. Moses is just a vessel. But it's the glory of God. It's the hand of God. Because he's the father to these children. Amen? And that's why some of us are stuck in our past life. We are still carrying those negative words. Do not be afraid of what people say. Because you are a child of God. Amen? Please rise up. Please rise up. We are going to declare that once again. Hallelujah. Amen? Come on, worship team. I want the drums also.
Slave to fear. I am a child of God. 'Cause I'm no longer slave to fear. 'Cause I am a child of God. I'm no longer slave. 'Cause I'm no longer slave to fear. I am a child of God.
Amen. Hallelujah. Please be seated. Verse 12 in Exodus chapter 3 and verse 12. You know, Moses is still with his insecurity. And he keeps saying, Exodus 3:12. So he said, I'll certainly be with you, and this shall be a sign to you that I have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you shall serve God on this mountain. Amen. The Lord will give you victory. More than anything else, how it would be, the Lord says that I will be certainly with you. His presence will make a way for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Those people who are sitting on your money, the checks would be honored in the name of Jesus. I declare it. I declare it. Because it's God who's going to do it. It's not us being great, our personality, the way we talk. It's all about His promises that He will do it. He is going to be with us. Hallelujah. Because I am a child of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today, I want your minds to be shifted from failure to what certainly God can do in your life. 100% God can do it in your lives. There's no situation that can press you down. The Lord will take you further. Amen. Amen. Moses kept saying, how it will happen? If Pharaoh says this, if this happens, there are no ifs. If we have a God who is a father. Cancel every ifs from your life. Cancel every ifs from your life. If this visit visa, I don't get a job. Cancel it. Because you will get a breakthrough. Do not let even a single thought of fear come close to your mind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Nothing will challenge us. Because we have a God whose cameras are over us. The entire heaven is ready to help us. Amen. The righteous falls down. The Bible says, may fall, you know, but can rise up. Bible says, I didn't say, 7 times. You know, Jesus cried on the cross 7 times. He cried for us. He cried. You know, Proverbs 24:11 says, the righteous man falls 7 times and gets back up again. Rise up, church. Nothing should keep us down. Nothing. Your appointment letter has not come from people. The heaven has given you the authority to business here. The heaven has given you the authority to work here. The heaven has given you the authority to bless this nation. Amen? We declare a blessing over this nation every day. Blessing over the rulers, because we, as long as we are here, we will bless the the nation, and we will see this land completely blessed for His glory. Amen. So if we bless this nation, the nation blesses us back. Hallelujah. John chapter 2 verses 23 to 25. Look at what Jesus says. Because of the miraculous signs Jesus did in Jerusalem at the Passover celebration, many began to trust in Him. But Jesus did not trust them because He knew all about people. No one needed to tell Him about human nature, for He knew that what was in each person's heart. I really admire Jesus. He knew what a person was thinking about Him every time He looked at Him. He knew all men. The Bible says nothing was hidden from Christ. Hallelujah. Lord, I pray, Lord Jesus, every whispers of the evil one would be completely shut in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, I speak faith to see those things that You have kept for our church, oh Lord Father. Hallelujah, Lord. For every person who's here. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 1 and verse 24. I want you to read it. Then they prayed, Lord, You know everyone's heart. Show us which of these two You have chosen. The Lord knows all our hearts. Amen? Maybe your spouse may not know you, but the Lord knows you. He knows every thought of us because He is our Father. You know, many a times, mothers, without speaking to their children, just looking at their children, they know. How was the day? And I want to tell you, sometimes mothers who are the best mothers may just go off to sleep. But the promise of the Lord is that He never sleeps nor slumbers. His eyes are over us. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank You, Lord. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Father, because You are a good Father. Lord, I take the authority in the name of Jesus, and I cancel every assignment of evil one over each one's life right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank You, Jesus. Let's read Isaiah chapter 43 and verse 10. Wow. You are My witness, declares the Lord, and My servant whom I have chosen, so that you may know and believe Me and understand I am He. Before Me, no God was formed, nor will there be one after Me. Amen. You have moved from being a child. You are a witness. Say, I'm a witness. I'm a witness to the Lord. You know, Jesus, He did not leave us. He said that I'm giving You Holy Spirit, and He'll be with us till the end of the earth. And when He died, Jesus, I want you to look at this scripture. Please turn with me to, this is a beautiful word, 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 18 to 20. For Christ also suffered once for sins, the just for the unjust. He came down as these angels came, as God came down, Jesus came down, the Holy Spirit is here, that He might bring us to God, that our relationship would be restored back as a child, being put to death in the flesh, but made alive by the Spirit, by whom also, look at this, He went and preached to the spirits in prison. Wow. You know, we are going to celebrate Easter. We are going to have Good Friday service. Here you see Jesus. He not only preached to the people here on the earth, below the earth, who formerly were disobedient, when once the divine long suffering waited in the days of Noah while the ark was being prepared, in which a few, that is 8 souls, were saved through water. God doesn't want anyone to perish. You know, we were praying behind, Pastor Jagdish was saying, you know, God so loved the world. That's so loved. We should understand the passion of God for us. That He gave up everything for you and for me. Hallelujah. Once you have a revelation that you are being watched, once you have the revelation that God will come and intervene in that difficult situation, once you have a revelation of the promise that He has spoken over your life, your hearts will become strong. Amen. And you will be a witness to the world around. You are a child of God. Amen. Please rise up, church. We are going to declare it once again. Every insecurity, we cast it out in the name of Jesus. Every dash of your life, I am not adequate. I am not competent. I am not able. I am not, whatever those dashes are, I do not know. You put the sufficiency of Christ in those dashes. Amen. Because Christ is sufficient. His grace is sufficient for me to take me through every situation of my life. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus. Let's all prophetically declare it.
'Cause I'm no longer slave to fear.
Amen.
I am a child of God.
This is our declaration, Lord.
'Cause I'm no longer slave to fear. Oh, 'cause I am a child of God. 'Cause I'm no
verses 15 and 16. So I said, Lord, who are you, Lord? We are looking at a statement here. Look at this. Read it, please. Beautiful. He said, I am Jesus whom you are persecuting. So, but rise and stand on your feet, for I have appeared to you for this purpose. You know, God saw. Jesus saw. He came down. Look at his declaration promise. To make you a minister and a witness both of the things which you have seen and of the things which I will yet reveal to you. Amen. It's not about Paul's potential. It's not about our potential. But it's about what he is going to do. It's all about him. Nothing about us, church. It's all about him. If you trust the Lord, then trust Him wholeheartedly. Don't be in two minds. I'm reading the last scripture which really touched my heart, and this is the scripture which made me prepare this word. Nahum chapter 1 and verse 7. We need to be confident of this. The Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and He knows those who trust in Him. Gratuity, for our bonuses, for our increment, for our business deals, for our relationships at home. We trust in Him in this nation. We trust in Him for breakthroughs in our life, for the life partners that you are waiting for your children. We trust in Him because he is a stronghold in the day of trouble. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's shift the focus on us, from us to him, because he is our heavenly Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. When you leave this place, you should be so confident. You should be so confident of yourself, because you have met up your heavenly Father. You have heard him, and he has promised you today that I will never forsake you. Hallelujah. 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 Let's worship the Lord.